алтан шавсарсан төрийн бас байгуулга нь Алтай нутгийн хөгжлийг дэмжих, иргэдийн амжиргааг дэвшүүлэх, ядуурлаас гарах ажлын байр бий болгох чиглэлээр үйл ажиллагааг Говьалтай аймагт явуулж байна. За Говьалтайчууд эрт дээр үес 10-ыг ардын тарайлангийн уламжлалт дарга технологиор тарайлж хүнсэндээ хэрэглэж ирсэн юм баялаг туршлагатай ард хүмүүс лээ. Тэгээ энэ хүү ардын тарайлангийн уламжлалт даргын технологи нь шинжилхүүний технологийн хөгжлийн гэрээр одоо хоцрогдож мартагдхад хүрээд байгаа юм. А энэ хүү технологиг бид хойч үдэг өвлүүлэн үлдэх, сургаж таньж мэдрүүлэх зорилгоор энэ баримт технологи санхүүжүүлж хийж байгаа юм. Канаг бүтээхэд бидэнд хөрөнгө санхүүгийн дэмжлэг туслалцаа үзүүлсэн Швейцарын хөгжил хамтын ажиллагааны агентлагийн суурин төлөөлөгч өргөмжит консул Маркус Дубахт хүн талархал илэрхийлж байна.
Spring has arrived in Gobi Altai, a province of Mongolia. Gobi Altai, carrying the mark of ages, the rugged foot of the mountain has barely stripped off its white cloak of snow. The eyes of the elders light up with joy, as if foreseeing the advancing spring and the departing winter. Infused with happiness and the peacefulness of the season, their cordial conversation is taking the chill off the spring winds in the valley. Gobi Altai is a land where mountains and humans have coexisted since time immemorial, linked by destiny in support of each other. As a tower of inspiration, the mountains have blessed their inhabitants with bounties and a satisfied life, while the people have worshipped the deities of the summit by offering their sacred devotion and the best parts of their harvest. Their age-old ritual of sprinkling milk has adorned this majestic peak with silvery cream. The locals living in the Altai region of Mongolia possess a jewel, an inheritance that has rewarded them with its blessings. This jewel is barley, a product of their ancestors' toil that has been planted and germinated in the soil of the land, cradled by it, and basked in the sun in its due season. The tradition of using a plowshare to cultivate the land and in the planting of barley derives from agricultural technology, which was developed by Genghis Khan in the 13th century. A barley seed dropped in the soil goes through 32 stages of processing using precise technology developed through experience and necessity before being served at our table as delicious food, such as tsambe, parched barley flour, nanchmeg, or hoots, a kind of porridge made with refined barley mixed with water. The process begins by allowing the barley field to rest without cultivation for 2 years before being irrigated in the autumn and seeded the following spring. The plow is just a simple wooden plow. With this plow, a farmer can till the soil from 10 to 25 centimeters deep using camel power. The farmer decides how deep to till the land after considering the winds in the spring, the moisture in the air, and the environmental conditions of that year.
Тэгээ цацтай юмстай тарай гэж чинь. Аавд нөгөө нь талбай дээр зааж өгчээсэн юм байгаа юм. Наадахчаа зүг дахиад татгаа тав. Тэгээд
The furrows are plowed and the barley seeds are sown in between them. The distance between the furrows is either increased or decreased depending on the strength of the wind on that given day. A standard coverage for seeding is 90 to 100 kilograms per hectare. But traditionally, one 6 to 8 kilo bucket of barley seed is used over a 900 square meter plot of land. After the seeding is finished, the space between the furrows is plowed and the process of covering the seeds begins. A traditional method using a wooden frame with round poles underneath is pulled over the densely seeded plot in order to increase adhesion between the seeds and soil. A sack of sand or some helpful children are placed on the frame to add some weight. Repairs are made to the irrigation channels and plot boxes. After seeding, optimizing the irrigation channels increases the amount of harvest that can be grown. The land of Altai is productive and fertile, but it yields its bounties only to hard-working people. The fruit of their labor would not seem so sweet if after seeding it grew spontaneously. Traditional barley production is a product of the labor of the whole community. After all, irrigation is the most important stage that requires diligent work and careful weather forecasting. Irrigation in barley agriculture is carried out in 5 stages, classified as groundwater, black earth water, braid water, teveg water, and swath water. For instance, braid water is crucial for yield and is used to moist the soil when barley is seeded, while swath water irrigation provides moisture for the crop itself. The water requirements and irrigation scheduling for barley depends on the specific characteristics of the region and the local weather conditions. Therefore, in a drought season, the teveg or swath water, or even both, can be skipped. At harvest time, the interests of men and animals come into conflict so that temporary fences must be put up. Nevertheless, it is impossible to do without animals, as they are part of the work from beginning to end. One of the unique features in traditional agriculture is that animals are the main source of power. The animal's interest in the crop is an indication that the crop is ripe and ready for harvest. First, a threshing floor must be prepared. The land is soaked before the camels tamp it down. These desert elephants, with their big feet, which look like a 100-ounce silver ingot, split down the middle, flatten the area to a fine finish that a professional polisher would be envious of. The sun that has been coaxing the barley all the way from seed to grain will do the drying. An inseparable part of the agricultural work cycle is the Mongolian custom of honoring the nature that bestows its riches. Barley farming had been abandoned for a while due to difficult times, but this noble culture has never been forgotten by people. In due time, the tools inherited from parents and grandparents were gathered so that a thick ripple of harvest has been revived by an unstoppable power of people, favored by heaven and Hangai. As the head approaches maturity just before the end of its intermediate stage of ripening, between the milky stage and the stage of complete hardening, it can be cut and dried. They cut the barley before full ripening occurs. Each person takes responsibility for one strip and everyone moves ahead in a row. After cutting the crop, the stalks are placed in the same direction in a stack. The stack is then carried, either in small loads on the back or in a basket loaded on a saddled camel, to the threshing floor, depending on the distance. The advantage of doing all the work by hand, from tilling to harvesting, using no machinery, is an optimal harvest yield with less waste and minimal cracking and breakage of heads. According to a tradition from long ago, barley farmers left some fallen heads of barley to be collected by the bashkachin, the local poor, as an act of charity. During harvesting and threshing, special attention is paid to guarding the crop so as not to lose it to birds and animals.
Одоо хүнс хангамж таар байх үед 90 ард тэм үүрэг доо хүнсээ хийж байснаас гадна аваа юмгараа би наадлын сумууд а завхны урдлын сумуудын одоо ард тэм одоо энэ гэрч одоо худалдаалж арилж анаамаа хийж одоо хүнсний хэрэгцээ хангаж байсан байх юм. Ингээд 10 тариа бол өөрийнх нь бусдаас одоо хамгаал бас хэд хэдэн онцлогтай. А энд одоо шувуу нэтийн одоо амтлд одоо сон шийтгэхээс биш өөр одоо мэрэгчд одоо энд үрдэг. Энэ гэхээр бол өөрийнхөө одоо хамгаалахын тэмтрүүлтэй маш хурц одоо сахал хуягтай байдаг учраас хэрийн одоо амтын авч идэж чаддаг. Аниур хонсогтой. За ингээ гэхээр бай одоо айл дотлоор уршуу нутгаар одоо их хоорондоо эвсэж хүн бүлөө нэгтгэж хүчээ нэгтгэж газар тарэлийн багаж төхөөрөмжөө нэгтгэж ингээ тарьж ирсэн их уламжлалтай.
Да,
The grain is carefully placed on the threshing floor, but must be thoroughly dried prior to threshing. The grain is piled on the threshing floor and left for 3 to 5 days before being turned over again. When an ear of grain breaks off the stalk at the touch of a wooden log, the grain is considered to be completely dry. Proper drying is crucial to maximize the yield of the barley harvest, because damp grain is more likely to produce waste. Depending on the size of the threshing floor, between 5 and 20 horses are led over the dry grain. This is done after the morning dew has evaporated and the barley is dry again. The tamest horse is placed on the inside of the circle, and the rest are tied with a halter and made to trot in order to flatten the piled grain. If the floor is large, the horses rotate in turn between the piles. In this manner, the grain is treaded out. When the threshed barley straw is separated from the grain, it is used as fodder for the animals. Now, threshed by horse hooves, the barley and the hard-working farmer need an Altai wind. On a windy day, the whole community joins in the winnowing process to separate the barley from its chaff and hay. The force of wind determines how high the barley is tossed. After tossing it against wind for a while, the grain and straw are separated in a process called breaking off the tail. Although it might seem that separating the barley from the straw signals the end of a year's labor and the time for enjoying the fruits of their work, the cycle of caring for the land never ends for a farmer. During harvest, one must think of the preparation needed for next year. A worker calls wind by whistling. When barley is tossed up in the air, the crop falls down by its own weight and the hulls are carried away by wind. Then the chaff and straw are sorted and separated to be used in fodder. The only fertilizer used in growing barley is produced by the animals. At the time of harvest, people come to the field and bring their livestock to graze, as well as to fertilize the field. After 10 to 14 days of grazing, the field is evenly fertilized. This is an advantage of traditional technology that eliminates the need for hauling and applying the fertilizer. After winnowing the crop, it is sifted with a sieve once more. This is the final process to separate the grain for food and for next year's seed. An advantage of traditional farming is the final product that is pure barley, except for a couple of stray hulls. During winnowing, farmers use a unique traditional method of sorting the grain. A shovel of grain is tossed into the wind, and the grain that falls nearest to the farmer's feet is taken for seed, as it is the heaviest. The lighter grains fall further away. The elders of the community use this process of sorting and separating barley to decide what should be used for planting, for food, for giving to others, and for grain to be sold. The people gather together to learn from the elders' knowledge. Recently, people have begun to show more interest in agriculture and farming, and the elders are especially proud to be able to share their knowledge with the younger generation that are beginning to like the taste of what the land offers them. At a time when barley and plow were almost forgotten and abandoned, there is hope that traditional barley production will be revived and prosper once again, thanks to the generous land and the ones who have undertaken this effort. Barley seed separated from the harvest for the planting of next year's crop is poured into a cache and covered with straw to hibernate until the following spring. This is a tradition passed down for generations, believing that by entrusting the barley seed to the elements of nature, it will be well preserved. The size of a cache used to store the barley seed is determined by the size of the harvest that year. A 1 cubic meter cache can hold between 580 to 700 kilos of barley seed. The cache is dug near the threshing floor. Now, the lion's share of the work is done. In the valley, the land is stripped bare, and piles of straw are seen in place of the waving barley plants. Only then will the hooves of swift horses be heard, and the harvest celebration can begin. Traditional summer celebration, called Nadam, is held to celebrate a prosperous harvest. Horse racing is one of the main attractions. The horses have made the turn and are heading back towards the finish. In the area near Bigger, Gobi Altai, there are a few historical places that have been known for cultivating barley. Preserved for centuries, the traditional farming methods had outlived the socialist revolution and have continually supplied the needs of its people. Especially during World War II, when food was scarce, the elders remembered barley as a means to their own survival. The fact that the community of Bigger did not supply only their own needs during the hard times, but also their neighbors, demonstrates the size of their farms. Today, a new generation of farmers has worked hard to revive the traditional methods, using them throughout the
1990s.
The horses are coming. The farmers that have contributed to the revival of planting barley in the Altai region are beginning to reap the fruits of their labor. The time has come to share the seed measured from the seed box that has accompanied them all the way from tilling the land. Thus, it is time for celebration, and the racing horses are coming. People are not the only ones who benefit from cultivating this barley that yields a good crop from even a small plot of land. The waste from the harvest is good fodder for the livestock. People with barley and animals with fodder are more likely to survive the harsh winter storms. The tradition of using barley as a food is rich in history. First of all, the barley is cleaned of its chaff and then pounded in a pestle to remove the hulls. After that, it is roasted in a hot cast iron pan, which keeps a constant temperature and prevents barley from either being burnt or being undercooked. It must be continually stirred in order to be roasted evenly. Pearling is the process where the husk is removed from the roasted barley grain by pounding it in a pestle. Then it is turned into flour after the bran layer is removed. The taste of the flour and barley products depends on the roasting of the barley grain. Overdone, it turns brown and has a burnt taste, but if undercooked, the grain is not well crushed and the flour would have a bitter taste. Properly done, good barley would be evenly browned. After roasting, the barley is mixed together with the tail fat of a sheep and is used to make nunchmik. Fried with cream and milk, it would become tosolsun barley. Moistened and ground grain is used in nutritious and delicious meals such as kuts. To turn barley into flour, one can use either a pistol or mill. Ground in a mortar and sifted over and over, the flour becomes whiter and is more refined than barley ground in a mill. Nevertheless, in order to grind a larger amount of flour efficiently, one needs to use a mill. In order to increase the milling capacity of the working surface, the surface is pounded and sharpened with a cast iron. To produce refined flour, the mill must be turned evenly. A man can produce 20 kilograms of flour per day using a hand mill, while mills driven by horses or hydropower can produce up to 240 kilograms per day. Delicious barley and the fragrant aroma of the flour turns thoughts back to this year's harvest, but also to the coming season's labor that will soon be upon us. The cycle of a farmer's work is never completed. In traditional farming, after harvesting, the most important work is the fall irrigation, which is one of the five cycles of irrigation common in barley production. In addition to manpower and animal fertilizer, water is crucial in making the barley grow. The spring and fall irrigation plays a very significant role. A field that has been rested for 2 years will be irrigated in preparation for planting the following spring. Prior to this irrigation, in September or October, all the irrigation channels are cleaned and the plot boxes are repaired, then redirected in the plot and boxes are filled. After filling the boxes two or three times, the field is considered saturated. When the water begins to freeze, the boxes are filled again. The foundation for the restoration of barley farming in Gobi Altai has been set. Nevertheless, more needs to be done in order to intensify the farming, increase profitability, produce high-quality products, and bring them to the public's awareness. The work of producing barley flour and manufacturing barley products has begun, but the funding of research and development work cannot be done by local and community efforts alone.